Welcome back to my kitchen. Today I've come with a new recipe which is nothing but a beetroot kesari. To start off with, let me explain the ingredients which you need. I've taken semolina, which is otherwise called rava. I've taken 2 cups of rava. So the measurement jar is say this one, like my 1 cup comprises of this. So for 2 cups of rava, I have taken 1 cup of beetroot, which is finely grated, to which I have taken 3 cups of, roughly 2.5 to 3 cups of sugar to it. So this is would be slightly more sweeter because my family likes it more sweet. So according to your taste, you can adjust the sugar. Then you would need 1/2 cup of ghee, then a little bit of kismis, cashew, and 5 glasses of water. This has around 5 glasses of water. So the first thing we would be doing is like we have to keep the water boiling. Then you would be frying the cashew and kismis. To the same ghee, we will be adding the rava. Once it gets slightly fried, we will be adding beetroot. Then once the raw smell goes off, we will be adding the water. And once it gets cooked, we will be adding the sugar. So let's start with the preparation. Okay, I have kept the water to boil in this burner. This is what I am going to add the ghee. I will reduce the flame once it gets heated up. To this I will add the cashew. The cashews have been fried finely, so now I will take it out. The kismis is also done. Let me remove from the plate. Now I'll add the semolina. Make sure that the flame is low, medium. Stirring it for some time till it gets fried, maybe say half fried. That is the time when you would be adding the beetroot to it. Now I've been frying this for say 2-3 minutes. Now I think this should be fine. Now we can add the beetroot to it. You should be frying both this beetroot and the semolina together until the raw smell of the beetroot goes off. So it may take another 5 more minutes for me to just fry this before we add water. So friends, I've been frying this for last say 7 minutes or so. Now I can see the raw smell of this beetroot has been completely gone and has been fried properly. So at this time, the water I had kept in my other burner had boiled. So now I'll add that to this. Cover it up and let it cook completely. right? Basically, you should be overcooking it, this semolina and beetroot, because once you put the sugar to it, it will try to shrink the you know, whatever the content in the dish. So basically, in order to, you know, we not to have a properly cooked kesari, you should overcook this with water initially before we add the sugar. So the same applies with the jaggery also. In whatever dish, especially the pie, some pongal and all you will be preparing, you should overcook the rice or dal before you put the jaggery. Then only the once the dish is done, this the rava or the rice or whatever will be properly cooked. So let me just cover it up and let it cook for say 2-3 minutes. So it was cooking for say 2 minutes now, and I was stirring this intermittently. Now you see that the water has been completely being absorbed, and this semolina as well as the beetroot has been completely cooked. You won't be able to make out the even the the beetroot grains inside, because it's been properly cooked and mixed well with semolina. Now at this stage we can add the sugar to it. Now I have added the sugar, and now let's mix thoroughly. The sugar has been completely dissolved, and the dish has become slightly watery. You don't have to worry about it. So you need to keep it the same, the slower flame for another 5 more minutes. So then this dish will be properly be cooked, and it will be in the desired consistency, what we would be looking for a kesari. At this stage, if you want to, give it a try, tasting those sugar and all, you can try that. I just tried it. So for me, this sugar seems to be perfect for me. But maybe if you want, you can if you want to add more sugar, you can add at this stage. So this been in the cooking in the flame for say last 3-4 minutes. Now I will be adding those cashews and kismis which I have fried earlier to it. So friends, now this is done. So maybe for one more minute of stirring, so it is done now. This is ready for serving. So if you all like my video, please just like my video and share my video. As long as also please subscribe to my channel to keep seeing those new notifications. Please click on that bell button next to the subscribe button.